I know, but okay. So I'm Parth Lavate from Tech Joomla, Pune, India, and this is something that I've put up in quite a hurry. I had submitted 3 different talks, and this was the one that I least expected to get pushed through. But it's there, and I have something to show you. Don't worry, it won't be very boring. So we have something ready. We can show that to you. So that's cool. So, just a little bit of a background about myself. I've been working with Joomla since the Mambo days. More of a site integrator initially, slowly started developing our own extensions. Our parent web company is TakeD Web Solutions. We are into Joomla, Magento application development, phone application development. We also work a little bit on WordPress, Drupal, but it's mainly been Joomla. And Tech Joomla is our product division, so that's a small team, 4 to 5 people, and we work on lots of different kinds of extensions. If you heard about Invitex, Gmail Alert, social ads, mainly social extensions, and some of them are general use extensions. Okay, so that's about it. I didn't really prepare any slides about that, so I'll just get down the point. So JGardens is something that we got inspired to create by looking at Drupal Gardens. So Drupal Gardens, Drupal, as you know, it's got a very high point of entry. I mean, it's very difficult to get started with Drupal. So if you look at ease of use, then probably it's WordPress, Joomla, and then Drupal. So because of this high point of entry, Drupal, some years back, it started a Drupal software as a service system called as Drupal Gardens, where you could just go, you know, choose a few things, and you could get a fully working, functional Drupal website. So we thought that it would be great if we can have something like that for Joomla. And the second point of creating that was that there's a lot of site builders out there that you can create, you know, small websites quickly. But the biggest problem of those is that they are not scalable. They are built out of some custom system. It's not easy to build anything on top of that. You have to just give it up and start afresh. So if you built it something like Joomla, it means that, you know, it could simply mean taking Akiba, and you could just scale that up without needing to go back to your drawing board. So those were few of the things that we thought while creating this. So how this helps is that it will make a simpler Joomla experience for existing developers, or more of site integrators. This will make it easier for you to deploy a Joomla website. So it will basically decrease the entry barrier, and we have fully scalable Joomla websites, no closed-source locked shitty websites. No lock-in, so you can change your host anytime. I mean, most of these site builders are, you know, like, they say that the you can't change the host, but here it could be simply about taking a backup, moving to any host you want. There doesn't need to be any lock-in. Probably the way we are looking at doing this is that it will be backed with support and training, so that people just looking at getting into Joomla can get the kind of backup required. It will be backed by extension support, so we are looking at tying up with extension developers so that in case people need support with the extensions, we can somehow give them a unified support system, which in this case the first level support team will raise to the particular extension developers and get their problem solved, so that they can go ahead with that. It will be powered by Joomla and delivered as a service. So I'm not sure if this is going to be 3, so that's the question mark, but right now it's more or less 3. So the first step would be choose a site configuration. So this is like a distribution or sets of extensions and a sample set. So if you say that I want to build a business website, that would probably mean Joomla plus probably some kind of add this extension and probably a blogging extension all tied together, and some sample data pulling pushed into it such that you get a, you know, full Joomla website. A blog would probably mean Joomla plus EasyBlog. That's it. That could probably solve the problem. Social network could be pretty scalable. It could start with Joomla plus Jom Social or Joomla plus Community Builder and some add-on extensions. So basically what you see here are site configurations or site templates or in effect distributions of some sort. So tomorrow if Jom Social or Community Builder said that we are going to create a distribution which is like Joomla plus Jom Social, think of this as a dynamic distribution generation system. Okay. So you could even make your own. Think of if you attended the App Store discussion right now, think of it like you marking a few of your extensions as your favorites and saying that, hey, I want these four extensions and Joomla and build a distribution for me. So this can do something like that. So customizing the configuration. So this is what we have working right now. So your extension list would look something like this. You would click on it. You know what extensions are there. You can switch them on or off. And what we are looking at is not just limiting this to extensions. You could choose templates. You could choose languages. Because everything is a Joomla extension, we can basically install anything that is a Joomla extension into the target website. And finally, this is not something that we are sure about. If we have some hosting guys here, this could mean that we could give them an option of four different or five different hosts. You just choose which host you want. We will do the checkout for you and we will deploy the site on the host. Or probably it could also mean that this could be hosted on one of the hosting company websites and they can do the deployment on their own server. So finally it would be confirmation and building. So let's do a quick demo so that you know how it works. So right now it doesn't have all the three steps. I'm only showing extensions right now. But the way the system has been built, we can install any kind of a extension package, which means languages, templates, sample data, whichever it might be. So I can decide that, hey, I don't want JBolo. Let me take out Jom Social. I'll just go with Broadcast, Chica Shop, and Comments. And probably this could also mean that we don't need to show the brands. It could simply be showing them as features. I want a chat feature, I want a commenting feature, I want a social broadcasting feature. Just excuse the speed, this is sitting in a, the server is sitting in our office in India. So that and the Wi-Fi might not show it as fast as it can be. We are using Red Shop, if there is anybody from Red Shop, for the e-commerce checkout. So what we are looking at doing here is that this could have commercial extension as well as free extensions. And we could, take your extensions to the end user, and as part of the common checkout for getting that site, we can also sell your extensions through the system. Right now I've removed all the rest of the e-commerce flow to make it simpler, but assuming we're saying selling paid extensions, there'll be a cart where you confirm and you pay and then you check out, and that's when this will start happening. So how fast was that? I think under a minute. So right now if you see, we are creating these flowers. The order ID is the unique key that we are using to create the site instances. And usually what will happen is that since I wasn't sure I'll get an internet connection here, we have switched off the emailing. So at this point an email is sent to the site owner saying that this site is ready and this is your access detail and stuff like that. Right now we are setting a common password, but that usually will be randomly generated an email to the users to make sure that there is nothing happening manually in between. So there you go, that's Joomla 2.5. The components that we selected are installed, that's Broadcast, Chica Shop. And at this point we are not doing any sample data installations, so if you want a pre-configured extension, that can go in. And that depends on the sample data, depending on what kind of website you are deploying. So that's just about building that sample data and deploying it. Yeah. So I think Chica Shop has a post installation process, so even that's not a problem. If the extension has a post-installation process, it comes to the screen, you just click on the complete installation or whatever, and it will take care of that. But again, if we do the sample data part of it, this doesn't need to come into picture because the extension will provide its sample data and then it can be completely installed. So like we did this for extensions, we have tried it out with templates, plugins, language files, everything can be installed. And the way we have done it is that what we have done is we have built a REST web service for the Joomla installer itself, so that any extension file that we pass to it, it will install. And it's backed by authentication key. So this is something that could even be probably the easiest way to do the app store that we were talking about. Because this REST web service is there, we are using the Joomla installer itself. So we are not complicating things by running a parallel process for installing the extension. We are already doing what the Joomla installer does. We are just exposing it as a web service. So that's it from the demo perspective. But if you want, have you taken a look at what Drupal Gardens does? So this is what we are envisaging. Probably I'll show you a short demo of that as well once I complete the presentation. Okay. What's happened? Sorry about that. Alt-tab. No, that's not working. I think it's the screens are getting mirrored. Sorry. Good. Yeah. So what next? This is a harder part. We're looking at also building a configuration wizard and a design wizard. But that is a little complicated to do because it requires a lot of integration with how Joomla extension developers develop their extensions. And how, again, we have like, 12 template frameworks, everybody having their own style of doing things. So that design wizard is going to be tough. Probably what could be done is that we could go with one template framework and then build that. That'll be easy because almost every template framework has something like this to allow us to do it, but supporting multiple probably will be a problem. In case of the configuration wizard, that should be easily doable. If you look at how iOS does its settings all in one place, so probably Joomla 3.0 will take care of some parts of that, where a configuration wizard won't be so hard to build. So in case we do that, it will be very extension specific, or we might tie up with various extension developers to make it easier. So think of it like if your Joomla, if your extension configuration has like 50 fields, look at probably exposing 10 or 15 of those to make it easy to configure, to get the basic configuration to run out, and then let them go to the advanced configuration area where they can go and explore what's required. So in terms of business models and partnerships, as I said, I wasn't ready to do this presentation fast. But we have some ideas. So one thing might be to just sell licenses of the system to hosts and let them control what they want to do. So I think somebody had pointed out earlier that to only have some extensions as part of his build. So that's completely possible. The extension list that you saw earlier that was generated, that's coming out of our own repository. But ideally, if we do something like the Jed App Store and it can expose a repository, then that list will be generated from there. So you could have filters and whatnot. So that's completely possible. The second option, which is going to be more complicated, is to run the system on the cloud, do remote deployments to hosts, and probably earn on the affiliate commission. So exactly like what affiliates do right now, but give people an easier way to give them a streamlined experience to create and generate their website. So template clubs and extension devs, the good advantage for this is that once people come to Joomla through a easier way, there'll be a direct distribution to the clients via the site builder. And if we do the app store, effectively within the site. So this was somewhere where we were going with it, because when you build a site through a builder like this, then people, if they want more features, you have to be able to let them add those more features. And that's exactly what the App Store would do if that's built by Joomla. Otherwise, probably a simpler version, which works exactly like what I showed you right now, will be done. So I'm not sure how the payment and stuff would work out, but it's easy to do. And languages, again, as languages are basically extension packages, but just having a language selection here is very easy. You can say, I want French, German, this, that. And we can just do that deployment as well. So that's about it for the presentation. So as I said, this was more, I expect this to be more of a discussion session. This is what we have right now. And as I said, since it's a REST web service, probably we're also okay to, you know, give the code to build the app store or do something really constructive with it, because what we have here, as I said, I'm not really sure how it will scale or how we will sell it, because it will be probably something that the hosts can do really well. If you have dedicated Joomla hosts, then this is a very good selling point for them to have an easy to build, easy to use site builder, because they already have a problem with people not knowing Joomla coming onto their this thing, because support is one of the big issues in something like this. So having level one support, probably somebody from open source support desk can take it up, and then, you know, get to the extension devs and do level two support. Okay. Hold on. So tell me, so what do you think? Yeah, sure. Right. Absolutely.
Do you consider doing some like REST deployment for CSV for the create categories and icons and icons?
Absolutely. That's definitely possible. That's the sample data I'm talking about, because the sample data, it can be pushed as an extension. You can push whatever sample data you have. So if you're doing, let's say, business catalog websites, they're like, you know, probably you are doing one website and 10, 15 other websites are exactly like that. So that's where the sample data comes in. And that's just one more push in the, so what I will probably show you is how this has been built. Yeah, so if a host was deploying this, this is the kind of flow that it would have. They will choose the domain name, they'll choose the type of website they don't want to build. Oh, I think that's twice. So they'll customize the extension list, choose the extension site design, choose the language that they want to do. And this is what I'm talking about, the App Store repository. The entire flow there, it's, if it was coming out of an App Store repository, it would make the system much more powerful. Because right now, the biggest problem that we have is that we are having to maintain this repository ourselves, which means that we, which is good in a way, especially if I were a host, I would want to probably say that, oh, these 100 extensions are cool, I'm going to only use that. So that is okay, but if somebody wanted to say that, hey, let me have more of a pick, then in that case, something coming directly out of the JED would be better. Then that's the hosting control. Then, hold on, where's the second slide? So this is what is going on behind the scenes. So after the login, choose extensions, fast checkout, the site creation is broken up into multiple processes to decrease the load on the host as much as possible. From folder creation, DB creation, Joomla download, extracting, installing, all that is done via shell scripts, which are separate because we are expecting that if the load went high, we are trying to break the process into as many parts as we can, and we are logging it such that we can continue at every point. So there is a continue kind of a support in that. And at this point, what we are doing is that we are copying the REST web service that we have done into the complete Joomla website. And after that, it's simply about passing it the extension, and then the Joomla installer takes care of the installation. So that sample data part is what is missing in that. And I think that is critical for this, because every Joomla site builder will have his own way of deploying websites. Think of it like when you build a small website for the first time, when you deliver it to the client, if you can just keep Akiba of it, of the sample data, then it's going to be very easy to keep on deploying similar things. And one more option in this could be that we can give you at the end of the build, instead of deploying the website, we can give you a complete package that you can reuse as required. That's also easily done. Right now we are giving you a Joomla website. Instead of that, we could give you a probably Akiba backup or something like that. that could be reused. So that solve your question in any way, or that was? So that would really go more of into the configuration wizard kind of a thing, where you say that, hey, you have installed K2, do you have some content, give me the CSV file and probably I'll create the structure. And so that's going to be probably even very custom. I don't know how you would make it standardized, because the data structures are going to vary by a huge margin. I mean, you could probably do something, probably we build it such that it will be easy to extend it. And if you have a requirement where you are, you know, having very similar things, then you can probably build your own part onto it. Because doing it for probably thousands of websites and saying that everybody does this in this way, it's going to be difficult. So even that configuration wizard part of it, it's really tough. We have done this for a client for church websites. And for them, there is like 10 extensions, that's it. And then it's easy for us to build a configuration wizard, because we have said that these are the extensions we are going to do it to. And all we are doing is that we are giving them an alternate interface to configure content, I mean, configure the components and do it. So if you have a niche and you want to deploy something like that, yes, we can do that. But that'll be something that we do custom for you on a fixed set of extensions. Because, I don't know, I mean, having an API for that, doable, but probably very hard. This is, I mean, practically ready. So if you are looking at a niche deployment, like I said, this was done for church websites. If you have something like a specific requirement, then it could be, it's very, very much ready. It's already been deployed in stable on a, you know, a very fixed kind of a flow. It's already working there. But here what, as I said, this is open discussion. You tell us, how would you like this to go forward? Because we are even open to, you know, open sourcing this, letting this be used as a, you know, distribution builder rather than a site deployer. Because see, this product isn't big, it's not something great. I'm sure a lot of people have done it, because it's the support and the service that is going to sell it in the end. Not the, I mean, creating a distribution, probably you could write a Flink script to do everything that has been done here. Not something special, but the user interface, making it really cool. Because if you look at Drupal Gardens, they have done an amazing job. So that's what Drupal Gardens is. Though they do take more time to create a website than we do. So you can say, what is that? What? Oh. Yeah. Oh, I would change the password. Okay. Is that fine? Hopefully, yes. So, if you see what they've done here is that these are the site configurations that I'm talking about you could go with. They are very basic stuff. In Joomla, I'm sure we could do it in a much better way. But this is being run by Acquia. They own Drupal, so it's like, you know, it's a very different ball game out there. So you can say, I want a campaign website. So if you're doing a small email campaign or something, or a marketing campaign, and you want to support that, so you can say what features I want. So all this is really extensions. They're just being expressed as features. I can say I want that. And somebody time that. But the output is way better. They are doing sample data installation, template installation, so the site looks very finished. You could probably spend a day on it to get the content done and you have it. But if you see, they are not going into too many complications. They're basically doing content websites. It's a blog or basically a product website or a campaign website where the content is important, probably social sharing and stuff, but no complications, because I'm sure it's going to be a nightmare to support it if you're installing JOM Social and probably social ads and all that. A lot of extension going in there. We are looking at basically it, as I said, it's very much probably the way the App Store would handle it. It could be like that, or we could say that give us our own repository, we will sell them off this site and we will give you, we'll send the sales of the proceeds of the sale to you. And we can do it such that, I mean, again, the extension developers buying into this is as important, otherwise this is not going to work. Or the easier thing would be probably, not too complicated, probably we'll just send you a report of the sales of the month and send you whatever happens. So you'll have to trust us there. Or if we are looking at investing more into it, we could do a small API which sends you an email every time a sale is made of your extension. What happened to them? Oh yeah, so the site is ready. So an API is definitely possible, or probably every time we sell your extension, we send you an email with the order ID and whatever you have made out of it. That's definitely possible. So a nice looking site with Drupal. So what these guys are doing, this is completely possible. What is where they're winning is this. So you can manage content. Basically, they have built a alternative admin interface of sorts, which lets you manage this kind of website easily. Editing content, edit in place. Probably the Joomla Shine guys, what they have done with the admin template, that would be a really good fit in this kind of a situation, because we are looking at creating sites for very simple requirements. The same thing can be used for complex requirements, but as I said, then the support problem comes into picture. Deploying it isn't a problem, supporting is. So that's what we have. So any other questions or ideas as to how this could be taken forward? The idea is nice, I guess, but it's very hard to implement it. And as I said, if we go ahead with the App Store, things like this will be much easier, because at its base, the concept is the same. The easiest thing we could do is we could use the code for the App Store, because the installations are, we can give you an interface where you see all extensions and install. That's already done in that. I love to keep running the demo till you think. So let's see how JOM Social goes. That's a pretty big extension. Acquia owns it. There are no commercial extensions in the Drupal infrastructure. So Acquia is selling it as a Drupal as a service. So if you look at Drupal Gardens, actually they are making a lot of money on this, I think, because they are the plans are per 100 users or per 200 users and stuff like that. So it's not even in MBs. There's megabyte limits, there's user limits, there's quite a few restrictions then. Yeah, that's where I'm talking about the configuration wizard.
Yeah.
That kind of a thing will probably make it a success. Yeah. But again, in that case, the entry for extension developers to it will be very restricted. They will have to say that, hey, we are willing to give you this kind of a wizard extension that will allow you to do that. So if you look at the pricing model, where do we have it? Yeah, pricing. So the pitch is you get a Drupal, free Drupal website, but the bandwidth is 5 GB, storage is 50 MB, and members is 5. So it's practically nothing. That's what they're doing. So they're even controlling the web form responses and stuff like that. because the set of extensions is very limited when they're giving this, so this kind of a pricing model is fine with that. But if any of you is a host and you're looking at partnering into doing something like what Drupal, I mean, if you're a host, you could do it easily because you have the main infrastructure to support Joomla and, you know, provide support to Joomla users. So they're basically selling service, yeah. Which is what the case, so, I mean, it is hosting plus service.
Yeah.
Exactly. Absolutely. That's all about lowering the lowering the barriers is that more users start using Joomla. Of course, it's going to mean a hell of a time for the developers because they're going to have to support the most idiotic requests. But that's fine. I mean, you're going to increase the market size by a big deal, so and make a lot of money out of it. So I guess the extra support is well worth it. But if it's made simple, as you said, then obviously the support is not going to be as high either. So, our site should be ready by now.
Yes, well, I got a question. Your Joomla release is running by RedShop?
It's using RedShop right now. It's using RedShop. So the repository is tied to a product. So every product in RedShop has a repository ID, which is how we are pulling the extension files from the repository. Mm-hmm. We started it with the e-commerce extension itself because at some point we might want to add commercial extensions to it, have some kind of a commercial, extension developer relation such that we are able to sell their extensions of this concept. So, I mean, it could have been done as a custom extension, but we thought, you know, what we are really building is a cart. Whatever you have in the cart creates a website. So, so now we have all the components that we selected: broadcast, Ika Shop, Jebolo, John Social, comments. Everything is in there. Yeah, so you'll see that in case of Jom Social, since it has a post install process and we are not doing any kind of sample data, we have to complete this installation. So what do you think the ideal next step would be? What would be the easiest way to take this to the end users? Yeah, they are already doing one click. It's just the extensions that we are doing extra. That's it, really, actually. Because, for example, Cloud Access already offers you a one click Joomla installation. What we are doing is that think of it like basically this idea at some point came from we did a Magento deployment for a web server company, and they had this shop where you could buy. I mean, it's typical if you looked at Dell.com or where you can build your own server. So we did a web service-based deployment with their actual deployment systems, where you could build your server, go manage your server, and then you could say that, hey, I need more RAM or I need some more CPU. And we were out of their hosting management system. So think of it like buying RAM out of cPanel or buying extra stuff out of cPanel. So as I said, this is a hybrid between you first configuring the site, buying stuff while building the site, and then there's the App Store where you say that, hey, I also need this, and I get those extra items built on. So at the base of it, it's basically a Joomla site builder. So one click installs plus extensions that you need and one step checkout. So one place to get everything instead of, you know, going all around. So now this is John Social taking time, right? Not my mistake. That's because it downloads Zen from their server, so it's taking time over Wi-Fi. But we have tried this with basic sample data, and then all this is skipped because what we do is that we do a sample data set, which is extra files that are downloaded by extensions, or and that can be provided by the extension developers as well. So the main reason, I guess, they don't do that is because they want to take the latest version of Zend off the this thing. Otherwise, it's all the other extensions, they should work out of the box. So that's about it, generally. So it's up to us how to continue this going forward. Yeah? All right, cool, thank you. This is the first time I have had almost a full room at JAB, so I think what warrants.